seed. Okay, so as you all can see the picture here, I've taken and drawn a picture of a seed. I've taken a beet seed. So in your book also we have it. Okay, so you can refer your textbook also. Okay, so as you, if you have observed a seed, no? So when you look at a seed from outside, externally, what do you see there? A covering, outer covering. No, it is colorful. Sometimes it appears to be in peas. If you see this green in color in that, different colors we have. Rajma, you can see, no, reddish in color. Okay, so that outer covering of a seed is known as the seed coat. Okay, and its main function is it protects the seed. Okay, the outer one, number one, you can see that. No, that is the seed coat. And you can see this number two, structure number two. It is a small hole-like structure present there. Okay, it is known as the seed hole. Okay, and this seed hole, the function of it is that it allows air and water to enter into the seed. You all know seed is a living thing, so it needs water. It needs air also. Okay, so this seed hole, it allows the entry of air and water into the seed for proper growth. Okay, then here, when you break a seed into two halves, some seeds, they cannot be broken. So it has, those are known as monopods. And seeds that have two cotyledons, two, it can be divided into equal halves. Okay, these halves, they are known as cotyledon number three. You can see, no, it is known as cotyledons. Okay, and these cotyledons, its function is to store food for the seed. Okay, then the fourth one, you can see the structure here. This fourth, it is known as the embryo. Okay, and this embryo, it grows into a new plant or a seedling. Okay, so these are the main structure of a seed. Now your work is to write down, list down those structures of the seed, the different parts of the seed, and you are going to write down its function. Hope you all can do it. So, number one, how are you going to do? You just write number one. What is number one here? It is the seed coat. And on the next slide, you are going to write the function. Number two, what is it? Seed hole. On the next slide, you are going to write its function. Okay, then number three, number four, same way you are going to write it. Okay, now please remember that the study of seed, okay, and fruits, they are known as carpology. C-A-R-P-O-L-O-G-Y, carpology. Remember that. Okay, so whenever you study about seeds and fruits, the study of it, it is known as carpology. Okay, now the next topic that we are going to discuss here is germination. So, you all know, in order for a plant to reproduce, seed should be formed. And seed, it has to germinate. And those seedlings that has been germinated can be grown into a new plant. Then only reproduction takes, or reproduction is successful in a plant. Okay, so now here, as the picture here you can see, a seed is there, okay, and seed is changing, you can see it is changing, no? So when a seed changes from a seed to a seedling, it is known as germination. So in another word, you can define germination as a process of converting or changing a seed into a seedling, is known as germination, okay, and this for a seed to germinate or change into a seedling, okay, there are a certain conditions required for it. Okay, so due to the presence of those conditions, then only germination can occur. Then only a seed can change into a seedling. Okay, now let's see what are those. Okay, a seed changes into a seedling or a new plant. Okay, certain conditions are required. Those conditions are, okay, the presence of air, adequate amount of air, light, warmth, and required amount of water. If these things are present, okay, the seed can change into a seedling or a new plant. Okay, all this things are required, or the conditions are required. All this should be present in an adequate amount. Then only a seed can change into a seedling or a new plant. Okay. Okay, these, all these conditions are fulfilled. What happens? Seed changes into seedling. And the process of seed changing into seedling is known as germination. Okay, so your work, you need to draw this diagram. Okay, and with this topic, I think so you came to know what is important for the reproduction in plants. We are doing about sexual reproduction. The last class we discussed about the formation of seed. No? And now that seed only is taken. Okay? And that seed, when it converts into a seedling, we take that seedling and plant it, it grows into a new plant or a new individual. No? So this is what reproduction, how the reproduction in plants occurs. Okay, in the next class, I'm going to send you a small activity. Okay, so it's there in your book. Okay, the activity is about the germination of seed only. Okay, there I can show you the process of germination there. So I'll be sending you the video next class. And along with that, next class we'll be discussing about the dispersal of seed. Once seed is formed, okay, it has to be distributed to different parts such that it can grow there. Yes or no? So how is it done? So that method is known as dispersal of seed. So that we are going to discuss in the next class. Hope this topic, so whatever we have discussed, the two topic, it is clear. Okay. And please do that in your copy. Functions you need to write. Name the structure and the functions you have to write. And the diagram. Okay, this diagram you have to draw it in your copy. And you have to decide what is germination. Okay. Hope you have understood. Okay, thank you so much.